Now, on the technology and science and knowledge, orientation or category or whatever, we keep seeing so many things, in the past, the near past. We see the explosion of the genetics, orientated, everything kind of focused in science towards understanding of, genetics, the genomes, and all such things. And then, you don't really hear about it that much. But then, out of that, like in the mid-90s, without really anybody understanding or having a general awareness, there was this explosion of genetically modified foods that were coming into online and being grown and produced. And they just kind of slipped those in under the radar without like telling anyone. I mean, I didn't know about it. I don't know about you folks who are out there, but whatever. But now, your basic staples in many parts of the world are basically man-made things. They're not by God's will or by God's design. They're not food in the sense that we think of them. They're not, when you say it's corn, it's not corn. I don't know, for example, GMO corn, soybeans, canola, cottonseed. These things are not what I mean. They have a name of being cotton, but then they're like, let's for example, or corn. I mean, they're called corn, but they're no longer corn. You understand? It is polluted. It is corrupted. It is changed. It is altered. It isn't what you think it is. You see. When you take that and you eat it, and it has a genetic material from, a bug or another animal or something else, we don't have any idea what that is really doing inside of us or on a genetic level. So I see this as a corruption worldwide of all human, the entire human population. And, they've outlawed GMOs in certain parts of the world, but we have to understand that, like in the US and in many Western countries, that's the only place that they have it. Like they say, like 80% of the goods in our supermarkets would just are banned in other countries. They're not, valid. They're not accepted. In fact, we ship GMO corn over to China, they won't even let them unload it. But yet we're eating that. They're planting that all over on our hemisphere. And it's in everything. It's not just corn, it's corn byproducts, high fructose corn syrup, corn syrup solids, this and that. And then you got your soybeans, your soy lecithin, your soy this, your soybean oil is in everything. I mean, this soybean stuff, and it's GMO. Even without being GMO, the soy is not food anyway. You know, somehow it's become food through some magic of marketing, but it isn't food. It never will be food. It's not food. And now it's GMO on top of it, you know. Okay, it's a hormone mimetic, we know that, you know. Now going beyond that and into other genetic issues, you know, so, but I mean, you don't know, you're eating this stuff all the time, it's in everything you eat, everything in the stores, unless you're, you know, purchasing staples and making things yourself, like I'm trying to do. You know, but you can't do it all. I mean, you can, perhaps. I haven't gotten there yet, but, you know. And there's hormones in the beef and in the milk and all that. You know, who knows what other kind of crap and additives they've been putting in there. We got chemicals, we got additives, we got colorings, we got all that, okay. And I've warned you about all this stuff, you know. I mean, I've talked about all this stuff. I've talked about the RF stuff and the microwaves. And, you know, you probably think I'm some kind of lunatic or something because of that, especially the latter. But that's really, you know, one of the most, probably the most sinister, deadly, and pervasive means by which, you know, the new control structure, the new way, the new world is going to be operating through and by such things, I believe. I believe that, you know, with the combination of everything that they're doing, you know, the GMOs, the chemtrails, with the heavy metal dropping the nanoparticles, the nanotechnology, nanobots, smart dust and such, and combined with such things as Gwen and Harp, that's HAARP, Gwen, GWEN. The smart meter systems that are like everywhere, cell phone tower systems, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, everything, you know, everything's wireless, you know, there's this, what you can't see right now, all around you, you know, is this powerful, those powerful signals that are, you know, can be modulated. You know, you can take a frequency and you can modulate amplitude modulation or frequency modulation onto each carrier wave, and each of those in turn can be used to, you know, because your mind, your brain, your body is an antenna. You know, your body is an antenna, right? You know that. I mean, you know, if any of you have ever, people who, you know, are older, like myself, you know, one time there was such thing as over-the-air television, okay, and these things had what they call antennas, like rabbit ears on the back of them and stuff, and you had to move these antennas and stuff to pick up a signal, and in many places, you know, you just couldn't get one unless you did all kinds of conniptions and all that, you know, but you understand, when you come up and hold on to the antenna and move it, then it comes in and you can see the picture and hear it and watch it and all that. And the only thing is, as soon as you let go, it goes back to static, you know. What does that tell you? It tells you that you're, number one, you're an antenna, and number two, you're picking up this stuff, and number three, you can transmit it to touch to the dead thing in front of you called a television. Okay. You know, I don't think I need to say anything more other than, you know, what are you picking up right now and what's it doing inside of you? You get it? That's a sine wave, okay? And everything has a frequency, alright? And you've got all this RF poison all over throughout your house, you know? Those little blocks, those little transformer blocks that you plug in and that can power and control everything, all of your electronic gizmos and gadgets and all that, those all put off a frequency, an RF frequency. Your Wi-Fi is another, you know, basically microwave technology in your house. I have a, you know, wireless mouse, and it's RF. And, you know, I've got a wireless keyboard here. Yeah. And these, you know, you don't think of them as being, you know, toxic or poisonous or mind-altering or anything like that. And maybe they're not, you know. But maybe they are. You don't know. I don't know. But, you know, I'll bet you there's somebody who does know, and somebody who's thought about it. Somebody who is not exactly looking out for you and your well-being, if you know what I mean. You know, there's always a group of people on this planet who are, you know, part and parcel of the destruction that is made and proceeds out of those people because they gain from it. You understand? You know? And there's, you know, it's said to be certain bloodlines and certain people, groups, families, and whatever, constrained, that have majority of the resources, you know, or control over them, and, you know, that's how they're being controlled, is that they control the resources and the money and stuff like that. But then that they use that to control us, but then they are also being controlled by that access to and control over their own wealth, their own power, and whatever. That's their weakness, you know, that they don't want to give up that control, that money, that power, you know. So that's their weakness, and that's how they are manipulated by the puppet masters, you see. And everybody has a weakness, everybody has a chink in their armor, everybody has an Achilles heel, or whatever. And, you know, it's the powers of darkness that are there to discover what that weakness is, work on that weakness, and then use it to their advantage. You know, so, we got this genetic stuff going on. We got, you know, now did I start talking about science? I did, kind of. It's kind of genetics, and then, you know, so going back to science and more into that, not just GMOs and the genetic stuff, but the mixing of the iron and the clay, you know. if you recall the recent, fairly recent, Google employee, this gal came on there and she was showing people her little tattoo. She, oh, see the tattoo? Yeah, you want to check it out? And he's like, yeah, can we get a picture of that? You know, let's get, you know, then maybe I'll stick a clip in here. I don't know. But, you know, she's saying, yeah, we can make this, you know. You know, it's a transhumanism. The blending of the machine with the man. You know, the miry clay with the iron, you see. And she was talking about that, marrying the differences between them. You know, like, she says something to the effect that, well, you know, machines are cold and hard and square and whatever. And humans are warm and round and curvy or whatever, you know. And see what I'm saying? But this is like the melding in the scientific mind, right? The Kurzweils and his cohort, the transhumanists and the cloners, you know, and you put them all together. And there's some kind of like transformation that they want to see happen, so that in effect the world substituting, you know, well, we don't need real corn, we're gonna make our own corn, you know. So you see what I'm saying, where the direction is? It's like, you know, so It's not just the food. They're doing this with the trees. You know, look it up. There's like arbor gin or something like that. Anyway, they're making genetically engineered trees. Why do we need genetically engineered trees? You know, we don't. This is just an extension and a broadening, and what they're going to do is basically poison or kill off everything that's natural. Okay, this is my thinking. And they're going to replace it or substitute it with this, you know, new genetic engineered crap. Everything's going to become genetically engineered, including you. You know? Maybe at one point with the food that you're eating, the chemicals, the toxins, and, you know, all these things together, maybe they can just push a button, change your frequency in your area, and make everyone act a certain way. Did you ever think of that? You know, I mean, it's been verified that they can control certain things having to do with emotion or feelings and stuff with certain frequencies. And my bet is that there's been intense in-depth study of this. You know, there are technologies out there right now that using low waves or extremely low frequencies, ELF, to control people's thoughts and behaviors and perhaps make a form of psychosis or whatever. There's technologies out there for putting voices in your head, and you know, and I believe they've used this on, you know, on people like a Gitmo and stuff, where they basically, you know, they get people to think that they're talking to God, you know, straight on, or God's talking to them. And so then, you know, God, who they see is or think is God, because they hear it and there's nobody there, you know, they start you know, giving up their secrets and stuff. You understand? Yeah. There's a lot of applications for this.